Let's look at some of the signs of kidney disease in patients with diabetes, because we're connecting the kidneys here with diabetes. So I want to show everybody the graphic here, which looks at the very specific signs, and I want the doctor to go ahead and look at these specifically. Do me a favor, if you would, go through these again and talk about them as to what you see from patients.
Let me try to explain, and this is how I explain it to my patients, and over many years I've developed a way of explaining it. If you think of the kidneys made up of millions of little strainers, the sugars not being controlled eat up the pores on those strainers. Okay, so that normally kidneys filter blood and they prevent protein from seeping into the urine. As those pores are increased in size, protein starts escaping and you see a lot more protein in the filtrate after the filtration. And as more protein occurs, the tissue on the other side of that strainer starts growing to try to recapture that protein. And as it grows, it starts pressing on normal kidney tissue and destroying kidney function. So the first thing you will see is maybe some more foam in the urine. Kidneys generally do not give you a lot of symptoms until you lose 90% of kidney function when it's too late. And that's why we have to rely on labs almost exclusively. But the first symptom of diabetes, of course, would be the thirst and the frequent urination, but the fact that it's affecting your kidneys, you might see some more increasing foam in the urine. You may see, and then further on, as this process gets more aggravated or worsening, then you start seeing swelling of legs, swelling of the eyes when you wake up, hypertension. And these are basically very few symptoms that occur, and they occur fairly late.